Hello everyone, welcome to WSO2 webinars. Today we are going to talk about perfecting security governance and primarily how we do so at WSO2. I'm Ayoma Vijayathunga, a technical lead of WSO2 Platform Security team. I have been working with the team for about 4 years, almost since the inception of it. Mathurika Thivaraja is also joining me towards the second half of the webinar. Mathurika?
Yeah, I am Mathurika Thivaraja, a senior software engineer of WSO2 Platform Security team. I have been working with the team for more than 1 year.
Right. So in summary, we will first talk about how we have integrated different security checks and enforcements with software development lifecycle. Secondly, we'll look at different security tools used at WSO2 and different security automations that are in place. Towards the second half of the session, Mathurika will walk you through security vulnerability reporting and management process. And we'll conclude the session by briefly discussing what else happens to WSO2 platform security team to ensure security of our products as well as customer deployments. So if we first look at security in software development lifecycle, security must not be an afterthought in application development. The more you wait to incorporate security into your SDLC, more challenging it becomes and more changes it will incur. Therefore, at WSO2, we think of security aspects from the design phase of a feature itself. It's essential to get the design of a feature reviewed by other team members. So the team of reviewers should include software architects as well as security leads of respective product domain. The design is evaluated from different perspectives. We look at different threat categories defined in stride and see how they apply, and if they apply, how they can be prevented. Thereby, we prevent spoofing, tampering, repudiation, information disclosure, denial of service, elevation of privilege type attacks at very early stages of software development lifecycle. WSO2 Secure Engineering Guideline, which is a public document anyone can refer to at the mentioned URL, is used as the main reference point during the design phase. So this document shows our technical security recommendations that we have provided to all engineering teams. Right. If we move into implementation phase, WSO2 Secure Engineering Guidelines again becomes the primary security reference. All engineers follow security guidelines provided here during the coding process. So basically, this document explains what WSO2 engineers should do in order to make sure that the code does not open up any security vulnerabilities, specifically OWASP top 10 security vulnerabilities. Once the development is complete or partially complete, the developers can use Find Security Bugs Spot Bugs plugin, which is integrated into Maven as well as their development environments to make sure that the code does not introduce any new security issues. Since this tool is integrated into their development environments, our engineers can get feedback from this tool then and there while they code. In addition, so we validate whether these practices are followed by using pull request template. So whenever WSO2 engineers send pull requests to the source repository, they should fill in the pull request template mentioning that the Secure Engineering Guideline was followed during the implementation, and find security bugs was executed and the relevant findings were resolved. You can see a screenshot in the slides as well. In addition, whenever a new third-party dependency is introduced during the implementation of a feature, it is essential to get approval for that. So security scanning is a part of this approval process. If there are known security issues related to the particular third-party dependency, the approval will fail. Basically, we will not approve that particular third-party library. All right. So once implementation phase is complete, and once the pull request has been sent, the particular code must be reviewed by other team members in order to get it merged with the source repository. One or more security leads of respective product domain must review the particular code, and Secure Engineering Guideline once again becomes a main reference for both reviewers and reviewee. At this phase, it is very important to verify that the implementation has covered all the security controls defined during the design phase. So once multiple features are put together, there's a release. However, before proceeding with a release, there are some pre-release checks that must happen. So these include static code analysis, dynamic analysis, and third-party dependency analysis. If any of these checks uncover security issue, or if these checks are not done properly, the release will be downvoted by the security team. So basically, the release cannot proceed, and the product team will have to fix relevant problems and then do another release candidate. So let's look at these scans in much more detail. If we first look at static scanning in detail, WSO2 uses Veracode commercial security scanner, which goes through the code of WSO2 components and find potential security issues. During this process, we do not include third-party library source code because that is covered in a separate tool. So once the report is provided by Veracode, basically what Veracode does is it will go through the source code of WSO2 components and find code level issues, So once the report is provided, product teams will attach feedback to each finding, providing justifications, reasoning, or resolution information. All true positives must be fixed before proceeding with the release. Similarly, we use Qualys for dynamic scanning. Qualys web application scanner goes through a deployment of a product. That's basically the runtime. So it goes through the deployed running application. And it will make malicious HTTP requests and observe what sort of responses are generated by the application. Here also, for the items that are getting reported by Qualys web application scanner, product teams must attach feedback for each finding. Again, all true positives must be fixed in order to proceed with the release. OWASP dependency check is used for scanning Java third-party libraries. This tool will check National Vulnerability Database, NVD, for known security vulnerabilities. In addition, RetireJS is used for scanning JavaScript third-party libraries. Similar to static and dynamic scanning, Product teams should actually upgrade to non-vulnerable versions of third-party dependency libraries or provide justifications on why the finding is not applicable or false positive before moving ahead with the product release. Right. So this is the complete process that we discussed so far. When a new feature is developed, it goes through design review. During that process, security leads provide input, and WSO2 Secure Engineering Guideline becomes the primary reference. And once the design is complete, and when the implementation happens, developers do self-review with the help of find security bugs, and also WSO2 Secure Engineering Guidelines, of course. And once the implementation phase is complete, we move on to code review. Again, security leads provide support here, and also WSO2 Secure Engineering Guideline becomes a primary reference. So once all the reviews are complete, there's pre-release checks, Vera code for static scanning, queries for dynamic scanning, and third-party dependency analysis by using OWASP dependency check. So all the reports that are generated by different security scanners are stored in central scan report repository. And as you can recall, there are feedbacks created by team members associated with all the findings generated by different security scanners. These findings are maintained in WSO2 Vulnerability Management System. We use OWASP Diffic Dojo for this purpose. So we'll talk about this tool in detail after a few more slides. So let's talk about security tooling and automation. If we look at the summary graph once again, you can see that there are multiple tools at play. We do not want platform security team to become a bottleneck for all other teams. Also, we do not want to expose the complexity of all the security tools to our engineering teams. Therefore, we have developed some security tools and automations to cover these aspects. So Scan Manager, Vulnerability Management System, and Dependency Track are some of these developer-focused tools. So if we go into detail regarding Scan Manager, Scan Manager is a portal to start and manage all security scans. With Scan Manager in place, our development teams can scan a feature or a product at any required time without having to wait for WSO2 security team, WSO2 platform security team to intervene or initiate the scan, thereby allowing team to measure the security status of a feature or of the release candidate at any stage that is required. Scan Manager internally uses Docker to queue, monitor, and maintain individual scans. And it calls APIs exposed by our commercial security scanning tools. Right now, Scan Manager is capable of handling queries and Veracode security scans. However, due to extendable nature of this application, it is easily possible to introduce new scanner engines to the Scan Manager. So in future, we are planning to introduce other types of security scanning engines to Scan Manager. In addition, we are planning to integrate Scan Manager with our CI/CD pipelines. Therefore, whenever a release candidate is built, our CI/CD pipeline itself can initiate a scan by using Scan Manager and produce relevant reports. WSO2 uses OWASP Diffic Dojo to maintain all findings generated by different security scanners, basically. It's a great and active open source project. We have multiple feature contributions already made to the project, and we are almost near completion of contributing few other features. So provided a security scan report, Diffic Dojo will identify already analyzed security issues and fill in associated feedback. So for us, this process will basically eliminate over 80% of issues reported by scanners automatically. Basically, it will go through feedback that is provided during different pre-release checks and also while analyzing security scan reports provided by customers, and use that feedback provided by team members to fill in any newly submitted scan reports. Okay, so since this eliminates over 80% of issues that are reported, this saves a lot of time, effort, and rework for our engineering teams. So OWASP dependency track is used as a centralized system for tracking external dependencies. This tool will talk to National Vulnerability Database, NVD, NPM public advisories, and Sonatype SSO index to identify vulnerabilities of third-party libraries. OWASP dependency track will also monitor these indices daily to see if there are any new security issues that are getting added. If so, it will generate email alerts to the security team as well, so that we can take necessary actions. So apart from these major tools, we have some other tools that we use in daily tasks, such as the security advisory creation tool, VeraCode comment uploader, which is used to upload comments stored in vulnerability management system Diffic Dojo to VeraCode commercial security scanner, and we have automated dynamic scan environment creation scripts that we use to create product environments for Qualys security scanning. Then we have a tool for security configuration verification as well. Right. So now we are moving into security vulnerability reporting and management process. Mathurika will take over the session from this point onwards.
Thank you, Ayamma. As we discussed now, we follow several security best practices and security checks throughout the entire software development lifecycle. Even though we do so, there might be a possibility that some vulnerabilities can exist and might be a possibility that our products are exposed to new threats. Therefore, it's necessary to monitor and identify those vulnerabilities and take immediate countermeasures to ensure the security of our products from those vulnerabilities. That is why we treat security vulnerability disclosures with the highest priority. And we have a well-defined security vulnerability reporting and management process. Also, this covers the maintenance phase of released products in security point of view. So let's look about our security vulnerability reporting and management process in more detail. So you can see a diagram in the slide. So this diagram shows the process how we practice handling security vulnerabilities from identification to disclosure phase. So let's look at each step involved in this process in more detail. So in this process, first step involved in this process is receive security vulnerability. So we receive security vulnerability in different resources. As we discussed before, we do internal security tests and scans during the pre-release scan as well as when we introduce new feature. And also we get security scan reports from customers as well. So once we analyze these security reports, if we come across any true positive issues, we treat those as a security vulnerability. And also customers can report any security vulnerabilities, any security issues when they are using our products. And also we highly encouraged security researchers, developers, and free and open source software users to test our products and report any security issues they have faced when they are using our products. And also, for reporting of vulnerabilities, we have set of prerequisites that need to be met. So, to report the security vulnerability with us, we always recommend to make sure that you have followed the security guidelines provided under security guidelines for production deployment, because these guidelines might mitigate the security concerns that you are experiencing. And also, we recommend to make sure that you have applied all the security updates in your environment. And if you want to share any static code analysis report, we recommend to limit to WSO2 components when doing the scan. And for third-party components, you can use dependency check or other static code analysis tool. Example, we can use Veracode static code analysis tool. And also, when you are reporting a vulnerability with us, you can use our template, which is mentioned in vulnerability report template. So you can visit this link to get more information. So basically, that template includes information about vulnerable products and versions and high-level overview of that issue, and steps to reproduce that issue, and what is the impact that can cause to our products. And if you have any proposed solution, feel free to send to us while reporting the security vulnerabilities. So once you have met these prerequisites, we have separate channels to report a security vulnerability with us. So if you are a developer or security researcher or free and open source software users, you can use security at WSO2 mailing list. All the vulnerability reports are treated with the highest priority and confidentiality. Therefore, this security at WSO2.com mailing list has limited audience internally. And also, when you are reporting a vulnerability, make sure that you have followed our guidelines on responsible disclosure. So you can refer these guidelines by visiting our webpage, which is called WSO2 Security Vulnerability Reporting Guidelines. And if you are a paid WSO2 subscription customer, you can either use customer support portal by raising a ticket in your support account, or you can share the vulnerability using the security at WSO2 mailing list. So once we have received a security vulnerability, it moves to evaluation phase. So we always treat security issues with the highest priority, and our product team will take necessary actions to evaluate the security issue with the help of platform security team. So once we have evaluated the reported issue, it moves to a decision phase. So not all vulnerabilities will be a threat to us, because as we discussed before, we have some security best practices and checks during the secure SDLC, and also we recommend security best practices to be followed in production environment as well. So based on our evaluation result and these security best practices, if the issue is a non-true positive, we provide a feedback to a reporter by explaining why WSO2 products are not impacted by this vulnerability. And if the issue is a true positive, we report to a customer by accepting the issue, and it will move to the security patch creation and delivery system. Before we moving that patch creation system, first true positive issue, first we do security severity classification. So based on that severity classification, we plan for the security patch creation and delivery process. And if the vulnerability has a catastrophic implication, we use war room approach to fix the issue to all affected product versions and deliver it to a customer's earliest time frame. So we will move to the security patch creation and delivery system in further. So this diagram shows about the security patch creation and delivery system. So let's look at each step involved in this process in more detail. So first step involved in this security patch creation and delivery system is fixing the vulnerability and also create patches. So if a security vulnerability is reported by a customer, we give a time estimation for customer to issue the security patch. So once we have done with that patch for the product version which they are using, we create the patches for all affected product version. So in this process, we create a security advisory. For creating a security advisory, we use our own identifier. So the own identifier template is WSO2 current year unique ID. For example, WSO2-2019-0501. So we called this as a security advisory ID to identify a particular security vulnerability. After we created the security advisory, the platform security team will review the security advisory and approve that. So once we have done with that, product team will identify all affected product version based on backporting policy. So let me explain about backporting policy in more detail. For the product version that were released before the second quarter of 2018, our backporting policy is to provide fixes up to 3 years or on demand for the customers who are using product version that are older than 3 years and have a subscription with us. For an example, WSO2 API Manager 2.0 was released in first quarter of 2018, means April 2018. So it's before second quarter of 2018. So we provide the patches until April 2021. And in 10-year long-term support products, for the product version that were released in the second quarter of 2018, and after that, the backporting policy covers 10 years for each product version. For an example, WSO2 Identity Server 570 was released October 2018. We issue patches until October 2028. After that, we create patches for all identified version, and backporters fixes are available to the customer either through the support channel or through WAM if the product version supports that. So once we have create all the patches, we fix in the master branch to make sure that our future GA release is not impacted from that security vulnerability. And also we create a public patch for current latest version. For the current latest version, you can refer our release metrics by visiting this link. So once we have done with this process, we move to customer announcement process. So it's a monthly process. So we aggregate all the patches that can go within a month, and we create a security advisory PDF for those patches and deliver those patches to customer. And also we do the bulk announcement to customers using their support account that they have. So if you are a customer, you can go to your support account and you can get these customer announcements that we have done so far. And if the issue is critical, we always prioritize that time. We do the customer announcement immediately rather than waiting until end of the month. So we do our customer announcement monthly basis, normally which is scheduled at the end of the month. And also what we do the announcement in every week. So since customer needs to be test this in staging environment, so it is not easy task for customers to apply these patches very frequently in their production environment and adjust their timeline with us. That's why we do our customer announcement in monthly basis. So once we have done with the customer announcement, we move to the public announcement. Before doing the public announcement, we give 4 weeks buffer period for customer to apply these patches in their environment. After this 4 weeks period, we deliver public patches through the security patch releases to free and open open source software users. So those users can visit our security patch releases page and can download the security patches relevant to the product version and they can apply. And also meantime, we publish security advisory in security advisories page. For public disclosure of a security vulnerability, we also same our own identifier, which we have explained bit before. And also those users who are using our older versions, we highly recommend them to upgrade to the latest versions to get the public security patches. And also users who download the products will get notification about the public announcement, so they can refer that. And you can get a more detail about the security vulnerability in a published security advisories. So once we have done with the public announcement, the security patch creation and delivery process comes to end. After that, we check whether the security vulnerability is reported by an external reporter. So if the security vulnerability is reported by an external reporter, we do the acknowledgement to them. For that, If a reporter is an external reporter and the reporter issues are valid, we give a credit to researchers in the relevant security advisory and also list the names in acknowledgement page with their concern. And also we provide the pack of SAC items and the security of appreciation. And it is no monetary bug bounty program, but there is a monetary bug bounty program conducted by the European Commission with the support of Integrity Platform for WSO2 API Manager. Currently, it is limited to API gateway that they have deployed, and we recommend to visit this site to get more information related to this program and to know about the scope related to this program. And also for the reporters who wishes to request to assign CVE from respective body for their reported vulnerability, we always support them to get it published. And so this is our complete picture of how we handle security vulnerabilities effectively. So now IOMA will give a brief summary about the role of platform security team in WSO2. Over to you.
Thank you, Madhurika. So platform security in summary. So you have already heard about what platform security team do at WSO2 to make our products and services secure. The items we talked about so far are integrating with external security tools like Qualys and VeraCode, developing security tools such as Scan Manager, managing external security scans, defining security policies and procedures. And in addition, we provide security guidelines to our engineering teams, similar to WSO2 Secure Engineering Guidelines. So apart from these tasks, WSO2 platform security team also train our engineers regarding security threats as well as security best practices that should be followed while engineering our products. We do security research on new emerging knowledge areas as well, and we try to bring in new developments in security domain into WSO2 products. In addition, we evangelize security within the organization with the intention of making our engineers more interested in learning as well as absorbing security. This is mainly done with meetups as well as internal capture the flag competitions that we conduct. Right. So finally, to get to know more about security at WSO2, you may visit our entry point at wso2.com/security. You'll find links to our acknowledgement program, security policies, security issue reporting guidelines, and so on in this entry point. So all the links that Madhurika pointed to, as well as all the links that I use during the session, such as Secure Engineering Guideline, are linked from this page so that you can use this as the primary entry point for all the things that are related to security within WSO2. Right. Along with that, we conclude the session for today. We'll look whether we have got any questions. So we have got one question. So if an open source user report a valid security issue of an older version of a product, will you provide patches to the reporter? I'll let Madhurika give an answer to that.
So we are using our security patch creation policy to create these patches for customer as well as public. For public patches, we only cover the latest product versions. But we will be able to provide the public GitHub pull request associated with the relevant security fix and a general instruction for backporting each PR manually to older versions. So if you want those security fixes, if you're using the older versions, so you can reach out us through the security at WSO2 mailing list, which we have mentioned before. And we can share the public GitHub pull request associated with that relevant security issues. But we highly recommend to use the latest product version to get the security patches.
Thank you, Madhurika. Okay, we have another question. Is there another way, any way to get only security updates? Yes. So actually, to get updates regarding WSO2 products, there's a tool called WSO2 Update Manager. So using WSO2 Update Manager, it is possible to get updates for the product that you use. When you use WSO2 Update Manager, it is possible to select security only channel so that you only receive security updates for the particular product. That's an option provided with WSO2 Update Manager. Okay, so another question that we got was whether there's a plan to open source scan manager. Actually, even now it's the source code is open through WSO2 GitHub repository under security tools repository, but we are planning to make it a separate project soon and make it much more interactive with the open source community. Okay, seems like there's a question regarding one of our slides. Let me quickly move back. Yes. So actually the question was whether we have mistakenly placed product team and platform security team in the interchange positions in some of the diagrams. So that's true. Sorry about the inconvenience and sorry about the mistake that we have done here. So for example, in this graph, the initial reply is sent by platform security team. And then once the process continues, the feedback regarding the findings, et cetera, are provided by product teams. So the image that says product team and the platform security team should be interchanged. Sorry about that mistake. It's repeated in few of the slides. So that's all the questions that we have today. Are there any? Right. That's all the questions that we have for today. So thank you for joining the webinar and being with us so far. So that concludes our session. Thank you, everyone.